Tonight on the British Broadcasting Corporation's motoring programme, Mr. Clarkson samples a number of stylish coupés. Mr. Wilson on the subject of the lower cost of cars in Europe. And Mr. Nidell tests Jaguar's swanky new Tourer. The Ford Capri was nothing more than a Cortina in a sports jacket. Now, it had fewer doors than a Cortina, less space inside than a Cortina, and to top it all, it cost more than a Cortina. But when it comes to coupes, only one thing matters: style. If they look good, we'll buy them. And there's no doubt at all that Ford are still on the right track with their new coupe, the American-made Cougar. We've seen pictures of it and they made us gasp. We saw it at the Geneva Motor Show, where we learned that a fully loaded V6 will cost just £22,000. We've seen it in all the car magazines, and right now motoring journalists from all over Britain are testing it on the continent. But despite repeated promises, Ford have decided not to lend one to Top Gear for tonight's programme. And this, I think, was a mistake. You see, in a BBC Two tradition started by Have I Got News For You, people or things who promise to turn up and then don't get replaced with a tub of lard. So, here it is, everyone, the new Ford Cougar. And that is what it's up against. All these cars cost between £20,000 and £30,000, and pretty well all of them are excellent. But I'm looking for the best, and as a result, I have to start the elimination process by picking nits. So, we wave an early goodbye to the Toyota Celica and the Honda Prelude. As I said at the beginning, coupes have to look so good that you start to pant and whimper when you see one. These two fail the test. What I'm looking for here is Anna Friel, and what I see here is a brace of Judy Finnegan's. Mercedes, on the other hand, has got it absolutely right with the CLK. Whenever I see one of these cars on the road, I whinny like a horse. However, while looks are important, crucial even, value matters too, and on that front the Mercedes has a couple of problems. If you buy a fast one, it's too expensive, and if you buy a cheap one, it's too slow. Beautiful girl. For the same price as a 2-litre Merc, you could have this 3-litre Peugeot 406 coupe. But don't get excited, because the running costs are horrendous. Over a 3-year period, the Peugeot will cost a massive £22,000, £3,000 more than the Mercedes. I therefore don't care how beautiful it is, and it is beautiful. It's got to go. So, what am I going to get rid of next? Well, obviously, it's the BMW. For £26,000, the same money as the Peugeot or a small-engine Mercedes, you can have this, a large-engined 328i. But that's not a good idea, for three reasons. First, it's only a two-door saloon rather than a proper coupe. Second, there's a new model coming out later this year. And third, it's a BMW. So no one will let you out of side turnings. And now it's time to wave goodbye to the Volvo C70. On the upside, it looks terrific and does 150 miles an hour. But on the downside, it costs £30,000, and to be honest, the driving experience is a daunting cocktail of wheel spin, traction control interference, and turbo lag. Could be worse, though. It could be the tub of lard. This thing has a bouncy ride and just won't go round corners at all. Now this stunning 20-valve turbocharged Fiat Coupe is a wonderful car to drive, but in the JD Power survey, people who bought one told us the ownership experience is not so wonderful. Pity, really. So, with just two cars left, we arrive at the Nissan 200SX, which, like the BMW, isn't a proper coupe. It also has a Nissan badge and an interior which appears to have been designed by Lord Irvine. So, what's it still doing in the running? Well, I'll show you. Like the BMW and Mercedes, this has rear-wheel drive. But unlike the BMW and Mercedes, you get 200 brake horsepower for just £21,800. On a smile per pound basis, it's fantastic. This car reminds me of a restaurant that I used to go to in Barnsley. From the outside, it looked awful, and inside there were plastic tablecloths and horrid sauce bottles. But the food was so good, I just kept going back for more. However, it can't win because while it's a great car to drive, it instills no sense of pride. At night, you walk into your house without a backward glance. Now, you can buy any one of the cars we've eliminated and you'll like it. They're all good. But there's one car left which is utterly and completely brilliant. Here it is, everyone. The king of petrolhead heaven. The new Alfa Romeo GT V6. Now, I want to make something perfectly plain from the outset here. This car is nowhere near perfect. It's noisy, the driving position is suitable only for a monkey, and I just know that once a month it would suffer from PMT. Leave the top off the toothpaste tube, and in the morning, it'll throw a clock radio at you. At £28,000, it's also very expensive, and to make matters worse, a new model with tweaked bodywork and a 6-speed gearbox is due out in the autumn. And I haven't finished yet. Those rear seats are a joke, and though you may not believe it, the boot is even worse. Okay if you're a pea salesman, not so good if you sell broad beans. As a practical proposition, this car is useless. But would you just take a look under the bonnet? Never mind that that's a brand new 220 horsepower 3-litre V6. Just look at it. And when you see detailing like that brake assembly, you just know that this car's going to stir your soul with an egg whisk. The normal 2-litre GTV is lovely to drive, but this V6, it's a mini Ferrari.
The steering is just perfect. Then you've got this incredible acceleration, any gear, any revs. Oh, and don't worry about the grip, because this car's got the most amazing chassis. And the top speed's 150, I swear. There are only a handful of cars in the entire world round a racetrack that'd keep up with it.
And on the road, you can sit back, smug in the knowledge that it's making other road users pant with desire. It looks so good that even after a long, hard drive, you just can't leave it alone. The GTV 6 is daft, but I absolutely adore it.
When we finally get our hands on a Ford Cougar, sometime in the next series, I hope, this is what it'll have to beat. Not only the nicest coupe we've seen all night, but one of the nicest cars I have ever driven.